Hey guys, welcome to DevOpsSchool. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn about Rundeck. Rundeck is an open source tool that helps you automate ad hoc and routine procedures in data center or cloud environments. It allows you to run tasks on any number of nodes from a web-based or command line interface. It also includes other features that make it easy to scale up your scripting efforts, including access control, workflow building, scheduling, logging, and integration with external sources for node and option data. This tutorial is divided into multiple parts. Therefore, subscribe to our channel and go through the complete playlist. After going through this tutorial, I promise you that the concept and understanding of the Rundeck will be absolutely clear to you. But before we begin, let me inform you a few things about us. DevOpsSchool is one of the leading platforms which offers DevOps, cloud and containers technology training and certification programs for freshers and established professionals who wish to update and consolidate their skills in the dynamic IT scenario. We ensure that our training solutions are delivered by highly experienced domain experts with practical working experience in various verticals. You can join our all training programs globally through online platforms, and if you're looking for classroom workshop, then we have regular batches available in Hyderabad and Bangalore. Check out the dates and enroll with us for our upcoming batches. For more info, link and contact details are mentioned in the description below.
Okay, so the question which you have asked, the question is very simple. You've been using Jenkins. Jenkins is there from last so many years, everywhere in your project. So why do you need the Rundeck? So first thing is, Rundeck is not a new tool. It's there from last so many years, maybe minimum 10 years. So, yes, Rundeck is there, Jenkins is there. Now, the question is, where should we use Jenkins and where should we use Rundeck? If you have noticed me talking about, Rundeck has a feature of automating your task, operations task. Okay? So, Jenkins 2 has, Rundeck has a feature of scheduling a task. So Jenkins 2 has, Rundeck has a feature of getting the notification of things, of jobs. Jenkins 2 has, Rundeck has a feature of auditing, logging, this fine-grained ACLs too. So Jenkins 2 has, Jenkins is also open source, Rundeck is also open source. But here, only one difference which you can see here is Jenkins is being primarily used for CI and CD operations. Means the CI and CD means continuous integration, continuous development and deployment for your team. Okay. Whereas Rundeck is a self-service tool. Now let's say if you want to do some self-service operations on Jenkins, you may not be able to do that. But if you, and so what you can do, you can install your own Jenkins. That is one of the way. Okay. That's one of the way. But
can you rephrase the part which is self-service tool?
So self-service tools, I'll put it in this way. One of the example, I'm saying one of the use cases for it, because there's so many use cases. Now let's say you are giving a KT to your fellow colleagues. Okay, you say you do step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5. So altogether you give the 5 steps, and for each of these 5 steps you give the 5 steps script or 5 commands, script or command or group of commands for each of these steps. Now you say you do this, you do this, you do this, you do this and stuff like that. Now in order to give this documentation, what you have to do, you have to write this documentation, right? You have to write this documentation. This documentation with some description you give it. Now that person will try to follow step 1 with the description, step 2 with that description, step 3 with that description, and 4 and 5 and so on. So now this is something like a KT you have given. Look at the time which you have wasted. You have wasted a time where you created, you first you document your own steps, then return a steps for it, then put it in the documentation, send it to the person, and then person has also received the documentation, he has read it, he has tried to replicate the same thing with his own environment. Time is got wasted. This is one of the use cases. Now what happens in a DevOps, you know that we don't have a time. Time is everything in it. But you have to get the output for everything in a short span of time. We call it immediate release. Okay? So you don't have a time. So what to do? So rather than you putting all this information, step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and each of these steps, scripts or commands, and then plus documentation, put this in the Rundeck. Put it the steps 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put it the document instruction on the Rundeck itself. Rundeck support the document instruction also. And then each Rundeck job you will provide it to your fellow colleagues. He will tell, he'll but know immediately step 1, that is this description will do this one. Not only you can provide this information, but also you can validate that your instruction were working or not. You can validate. Okay, so this is one of the huge cases where you can keep it different. So these are the things you cannot use in the Jenkins. You cannot use in the Jenkins. Now let me talk about some of the other scenarios. You want to do the deployment using Ansible. Okay, Ansible. Now, if you do the deployment using Ansible on ad-hoc command, remember again I'm telling you, ad-hoc command. If you talk about the operations, let me remind you, Jenkins is a CI/CD tool. You do not do ad-hoc work. Okay, but in operation we do the lots of ad-hoc work. Learn something, forget something. Now, if I ask you 5 days before you run some commands, you will be able to remember. But what about I should use Rundeck for my ad hoc command? Okay, there is no time wastage of Rundeck. It is easy to the way you run. Again, I am repeating, the way you run ad hoc command in your development laptop, same way you run ad hoc command on the Rundeck. The beauty of the Rundeck is it captures the case, a log, what you have done, when is you have done, what was the output, and so on. So it's like auditing. You can audit your work yourself. You can trace your work which you did. So this is a one self-enabled service tool which is easy to use compared to the Jenkins in those things. So there's again so many use cases which I have discussed, like you can use for the deployment, automating the deployment task, you can use for the self-service driven environment creation task, you can use for the sharing the KT to your colleagues, you not through the documentation but through the Rundeck jobs, so which can be validated yourself and then you can also validate it with the documentation for the each of these steps. So lots of many things you can do that here. Okay. So yes, again, I agree. There are many features which is common in Jenkins and Rundeck. The use cases can be used in a different way. Rundeck is been known as an operations tool. Jenkins is known as a CI/CD tool. That answer your questions, right?
Yes.
Any other questions, guys? Okay, so now we have understood what is Rundeck, why do we need it, and then use cases of it, differences, and then stuff like that. Now let's get started using. So I am going to start a notepad. Here. And this is a notepad, I'm going to store it at the location which I'm going to share with you, similar to what I did yesterday. Okay. So some of the other inputs I would like to share with you is Rundeck. It is developed. Using Java. So you know that when I say Java, then you know that few things automatically comes. Rundeck is a platform independent. Why? Because Java is a platform independent. Now to install the Rundeck, you need the Java. Okay. So this is the two things that you have. Now the next question is, how to install Rundeck. So first thing, Java. Second thing, Rundeck, which is easy to do that. Now I am going to install Rundeck in Linux operating system. So let's get it. I'll get IBM's AWS quickly. Launch instance, so RTL 7.5. Name. Rundeck. I am opening up every port by the way, but there are few ports which are needed by. Rundeck. Okay, so this is the machine which I am going to use. My username is EC2-Fun. User. And let's use the property. Rajesh, Mumbai.
Yes.
Change setting color.
I have joined newly.
PC2. It's a user. Kumar. Now I am going to start the Rundeck. So I'll share with you that installation instruction. As I said, you can install anywhere, wherever you want, but I'm going to share a simple instruction which is here. This is the way to install the Rundeck. So first install the Java.
One question, can you share the screen with us?
Yes. And then installing, adding the repository for the Rundeck, and then installing the Rundeck. Now this installation, as I said, you can install through the var file also, but this I am installing through the YAML. So that way upgrade is also easy, starting, stopping. Now you can stop, avoid the multiple commands going here, there and all. So that it can be. Okay, now Rundeck got installed. Now you are going to start the Rundeck using this command.
And now if I see process table, here you see Rundeck got started. Important thing is, if you look at this Rundeck here, see this is the process which is running the Rundeck, and this is the process. Let me just exactly run, so that way it's easy. So the run has also come. So you see here, I hit the Rundeck. Here if you see, some of the security related Java stuff which is running as a root. But if you look at, go down and look at this, the one which is running the Rundeck, it is running as a Rundeck user. Okay. So remember here, Rundeck runs as a Rundeck user. But apart from that, some JC and stuff like that, crypto stuff like that, which runs as a root. Now, if you look at this line more carefully, you see here, there is a configuration file, and I would like you to focus and look at the each of this file very carefully, because this is something which will give you the lots of information. So let me give the screen here. This information has, this output has a lot of information. For example, you see here, this is the some configuration for JS. Now what is a JS? So basically, Rundeck is having the fine-tuned ACLs for the logging and stuff like that. So they use a JS module for the Java. So that is the one thing you can see here. Now you can see that what is the configuration directory. See here, Rundeck configuration directory, PPC Rundeck. That means anything related to the configuration of Rundeck, you will find it in the etc. Now you see there is one more path is there. This is called data store. Okay. So data store means whatever you create and write and stuff like that is written in this var list. The location is different. You see here is the etc, there var list. So these are the things you have to note it down. Now what is the server directory? This is the one. Then the project, when you create the project, where it will be there inside this location. When you find the log, where you find the logs for the jobs, and here you find the jobs for the run. And then configuration location, again this is the Rundeck configuration file. Okay, some of the directory, work directory you see here. This is the code on which your Rundeck runs. That is so important. And here you have a base location. Again some of the CPU and RAM, heap settings and stuff like that, and then some more configuration. So I would request you to please look at this. This is again logs location, some of the repetitive things, okay, config location, some of the repetitive things here, IO temp directory, and so these are the location which will give you enough information about when you install the Rundeck to YUM, then what are the things to get it. Now few things we got it for time being. Rundeck runs on this particular port. Rundeck has a configuration file which is here. Login configuration file here. Rundeck has a configuration file which is this one. Okay. Rundeck configuration file is this one. This is a place where the var file of the Rundeck is available. So if you want to upgrade sometime in the future, this is the changes you have to do. If you see the data directory, which is a database, which is here. So all this information you have got it. Now let me tell you here one more thing. Rundeck store all information, whatever you create through the Rundeck, okay, store in the database. Store all the information in database. But the question, remember, there is a difference here. Because Jenkins stores inside, not in the database. They store in the XML file. But Rundeck stores the information in database, which is called relational database. By the way, job configurations also is in stored in the XML for Rundeck also. So there are some commonalities also there. Now the question is which database? If you look for the pick installer, then they use by default H2 database. But yes, you can set up MySQL, you can set up a PostgreSQL, you can set up a Oracle and stuff like that. So yes, you can also do that. This configuration, once you have a key database, exist, you can configure at the configuration file of the Rundeck and stop and start. This is the thing which you can do that. So now what I did talk about, I installed the Rundeck and then I will tell you what are the directives you should see that. So typically, if I conclude, these are the two directories you should be having a knowledge with. This is one directory. This is another directory. And if you see that most of the things you can find in these two directories. So here var lib rundeck. Here you see etc rundeck, var lib rundeck, here var lib rundeck, etc rundeck, here you see var lib rundeck, var lib rundeck. Early rendered and all this stuff. So basically, if you remember only two directories, you can trace it back all the time. Here you have a configuration file in GCC. Here you have a data directory, jobs, budgets, and whatever it is. So now this is a two directory to look for it. Now if you go inside this, clear the screen. I think I lost the console. Guys, are you able to hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. I had lost the console, so I thought it may be my internet. Is it true? Okay. So now I go inside the etc rundeck and you see these are the files. You see, this is the properties for the log, framework properties, JAS login modules, all these things. Here and SSL related things, realm properties you have. If you want to enable for the LDAP and stuff like that, you can do this one. This is a main configuration file that database and many outputs and all is there. So it is there. Now if you go into library directory, this is a important one. Here, cd. You can see here jobs, logs, projects, here it will come. Working directory will create var, database will be here, some of the command line utilities here. So all this thing will be here. So this is the just installation instruction, configuration instruction for the Rundeck. Now let's view it. Now if you see that Rundeck is running, and I told you Rundeck is running, and the port number we only found root out yourself this level. So now let's run this and let's access this. So I am going to browser enter. Now you see it has come. I can see the page has come. Okay. You have to notice this because it has come. And here admin username is admin default. Okay. And password is also admin. And now you see here admin. Now if I hit the admin. It's going to nowhere. You see, it login going to nowhere. And it happened. And going to nowhere. So yes, you can see and now you see that. And one more stupid thing you see here is redirected to localhost actually. So how it has happened? So as I told you, Rundeck is a self-service tool. Okay. So that's the reason. Rundeck. Again, I'm repeating. Rundeck is hard coded. Okay, Rundeck default installation is hard coded with localhost. Okay, this is hard coded with localhost. So now if you check at the local host, let's say curl, and here you change this to local host. Okay. And then if I browse in this machine, and you see it's no error is coming, that means it's returning something. So here this is something like it's running but it's not accessible. So what to do in order to access on the host port, a public IP address? So I have to change something. There's a two files. I need to change it. Now let's change that file. And
This is the two files. Let me change it. Just do the copy paste. Yeah. So this is the one. To access the Rundeck with a complete access, you have to modify two files. Which file? This file and this file. Now you must be wondering, this part I never talked about it. So now this is a sign of user home, and inside that you are running the Rundeck. So basically, as I said, there's so many ways in which you can run the Rundeck. Using var file also directly you can run the Rundeck. But I did too young. So what is the file I will modify? I will be modifying this location. The file will be located at that location. So let's go to this file and modify. Okay. So now I need to modify this file and this file. Both the files I want to modify, and I need to hard code my IP address, stop and start. So now let me do one thing. Let me stop. The first thing I have to do is stop. As per the best practices. Okay. Remember, I am noting down all these things in the notes, so you have to understand that. And here, stop. Okay. Now I will modify these two files. And if you see, I have no desire to change. Number, but only this is the server URL, only server URL. Though you can change the other things also, but not complicating the thing. Change this, and then second one, I think the path is a problem. Back to start this file. The path got changed. So yes, the file name is Rundeck config properties file. It is here. Yes, this is the right path. Okay, depends on the mode of installation, path will change. Okay, so you have to be mindful about that. Now I'm changing from the local host to IP address. And now put this IP address and save it. Now finally I have to start. And then now let's start it. And finally I can access within a, you'll have to wait for a few seconds. It takes some time to load it. And finally, you got to come. Remember, you have to open up the port, which is 4440. ES-EF Rundeck running. Yeah, it has come now, and then you have to wait for it. Don't think it's not changed, but sometimes you get confusion. Now we try admin, and now I just enter, and then I can see that welcome to Rundeck 3.1. So this is the current version which we are using right now, and this is where we are going to automate all of many of our tasks, small tasks and stuff like that. But if you look at this here, you can go for the free sticker. If you want free sticker, they will courier you at your address. All the documentation you can find it at here, and all these I suggest, guys, please refer their official documentation also, because nowadays in DevOps world, there's so much of changes happening with each tool. So official documentation is one of the best way to get this right information. mailing list is here, track and channel is there. You can report any issues if you want here. Okay, and then you have to get started this new project. So far what I have covered, what is Rundeck? Why do we need it? Use cases of it. Enterprise, community versus enterprise. Enterprise. Jenkins versus Rundeck. Installation and configuration. Running with IP address and then localhost. So these are the questions I have just now covered, and now we have to start using the Rundeck. Before me getting into that, do we have any questions? Have any questions? Anyone? Any questions, guys?
So the Rundeck will use the inbuilt database, or is that
yes, will use? By default it's a H2 database. Okay.
Oh, H2 database. Okay.
That is under the data directory. I have shown you the JSON part, right? Yes.
Okay.
Any other questions, guys?
Yeah, one question I have. She said Rundeck uses its own database. So is it getting created automatically when it is being installed?
Yes. Then so actually, what happens in this property file? In this property file, okay, you have a that database default setup. So if you do not provide any other database, then that will be using the inbuilt database. That validation is in installer only. If you see here, I have just opened up the property file. You see this line? You see, and here you see. Yes. Yeah. Now, if you want your own database, no problem. Comment this out and then go for your supported database. For example, MySQL and stuff like that. So for that, you have to insert those entry here. Now, where do you get this information? On the documentation page, they have a profile line which you can introduce and get.
So just go back to the notepad once again. So you mentioned that there are different databases. So during the time of installation,
During time of the installation, no. What you have to do, you have to modify those configuration files before starting it. Install this normal way, and before starting it, you have to start with the different database. For example, let me show you that with MySQL. Okay, this is here. You see. Just you have to add a few lines in the configuration and start. That's all. So install MySQL, that's a different topic. Configure MySQL, that's a different topic. But what you have to do, you have to create one database, that's a different topic. But this is the things you have to do in your property file. You see here, this is a property file, and this is what you do, and then add it and start this. That's all.
So once we do the installation using the default settings, then before launching the local host web page for logging there, we have to make the changes to the file following these steps.
In the properties file, your question was the question was how to run the Rundeck with MySQL. So have this MySQL server database created, access given. That's a different topic altogether. But what I'm trying to tell you, Rundeck changes specific only. So to have this line, modify this line as per your username, password, database information, put it in this file and start it. That's all.
So my question was like you did the installation which we saw.
Right.
Just go back to the notepad which gives you the steps for installation of Rundeck. Here we did not mention that which database we want. So if we want a different database, then what would be the change in this part?
So here you install it, so far so good, right? After that, you have to follow this instruction.
Okay, that answers my question.
Before starting, you have to follow this instruction.
Okay, fine.
Or if you have used the H2 and then you want to migrate to MySQL, so migration also is there. See here.
Okay.
So this is a simple to do that, not complicated stuff like that. Okay. So any other questions?
Yeah, but can you install it on Windows as well or it's only Linux?
Yes, sir. I said, remember, developed using Java. Java application can be installed anywhere.
And one more question is, what is the limitation of the H2 database? I mean, if you are using it in a production environment, is it like, can we go with H2 or we have to change the database to?
No, it's up to you. You can change the MySQL. Let's say if your Rundeck is used by all of your team members, you can go for the MySQL or Oracle or whatever it is. But yes, many times, you know, you use Rundeck for the automating the your few ad-hoc work, self-service things, sharing 2-3 people, 5 people. Not so much you are worrying about the, you know, the good stuff, like enterprise stuff. Like backup, security and all stuff. Though the Rundeck is providing very, very huge, better security than Jenkins, but yeah, you may not need it if you are trying for your local host.
Okay, but if it's, we have, like, not, say, maybe 20 users are using it, then.
Yeah, then performance will be a problem. Then in that case, you have to go for the MySQL process, Postgres and Oracle.
Okay, all right. Thank you.
Any other questions there? Okay, so now what I am going to do, I am going to upload this notes, and in the chat window, I am going to share with you the location, and you all are going to install the Rundeck. Access the Rundeck, then I will work with the workflow, which is not that difficult. So let me upload this.
Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed and learned from this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest. Want to study further? Subscribe to our paid membership to get a deep dive into each and every topic. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to our DevOps School channel and hit the bell icon to learn more. Keep learning.